The Wall Street Journal, Kellyanne, is, as we all know, there's a wave of protests throughout Iran, the biggest since 2009. The president has been doing some tweeting. The Wall Street Journal is now quoting the State Department as saying that they will threaten the country with new sanctions unless they allow the protests to happen, right?
Yes, that's right. And this president, again, very transparently through his tweets, he said he stands with the Iranian people and he knows that they're looking for freedom and they're against corruption. And look, thank you for rolling that tape. I think America, well, the world needs to see what's happening in Iran
right now. That's what freedom looks like right there.
That's what freedom looks like. And this president stands with the Iranian people and he doesn't want to remain silent the way too many people were silent in 2009.
But so, Kellyanne, here's the deal. We know the series of protests came up, and the president did not waste any time in coming out and supporting the Iranian people. But as Senator Lindsey Graham, in backing up the president's doing something that President Obama didn't, and that is quickly support the protesters, said it's got to be more than a tweet. We understand there's one move that he just made by saying, I'm calling for more sanctions on Iran, but we really don't have much trade with them to begin with. What do you think the big policy will be? How close are do you think a major policy announcement about this? And who do you think the president's going to get most of his advice from when he comes out with a reaction to these Iranian protests?
The president is in constant contact with his national security and State Department teams. I mean, that's who he confers with. He'll have his daily intelligence briefing today. This will be a major issue that he continues to discuss with the National Security Council and others, obviously the Pentagon and his generals, as he says. And I'm not going to get ahead of the president and what he does next with respect to Iran, but he has made clear, beginning as a candidate, how much he disagreed with the Obama-Clinton lack of doctrine when it came to Iran.
It's interesting, Kelly, we only have 30 seconds left, but just your response to Susan Rice telling the president to be quiet via tweet.
Terrible. I wish she had been quiet when she lied about what happened in Benghazi and she blamed a tape when we know that's not what happened, went on five Sunday shows and lied to the American people about it. That would have been a good time to be quiet. You don't be quiet
right
when people are losing their lives because they're standing up for basic essential needs and for freedom. And look, whether it's Robbie Mook or others in the Democratic Party, a couple of people are starting to realize that if you're out of touch with Americans' primary concerns, if you're not for the working people, if you're not for freedom around the globe, right, look how much safer and more prosperous we are as a nation just in this last year. This president stands with the Iranian people in their quest to get basic freedoms.
All right. Kellyanne Conway, remember the president told, President Obama told the Warmbier family to be quiet. He saw what happened to his son. Thank you so much for being with us, Kellyanne.
Thank you.
Have a good one.